In this video, we're going to add some logic that allows the game to restart in the event that the ball hits this back wall by getting past our paddle. It's actually pretty simple. Let's go ahead and click on our ball. Choose Edit, and of course we're going to edit Behaviors. We're going to add another behavior here. We're going to do a collision trigger, so go ahead and find collision under the Triggers menu. And I'm going to bring this down. We're going to add the restart game node, which is under game flow. And there you'll see the restart game node, and I can bring that here. Next, we're going to connect them, but we also need to give a little more information. We have to tell the ball what to collide with in order to restart the game. So to do this, I'm going to click on collision, and where it says type, this is where the names we have given our boundary walls really comes into play. Clearly, we had named ours right wall, which of course is the wall over here. Some people may have named it back wall or computer score if, for example, you had two paddles going. I just named it right wall. But I need to make sure that the collision node knows that if it hits the right wall, and basically this is saying here that if the hit is on any location of the wall, including top, bottom, left, and right, it will restart the game. I'm going to click that here, and then, of course, we can test it. And it restarted the game, so we know it works. So go ahead and add the restart game logic. In the next video, we're going to look at adding a second player, which is a lot of fun. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.